SMT Nation, let me have a moment of your time so I could tell you a little bit about our partner, Southern New Hampshire University, otherwise known as SNHU. SNHU is a great opportunity for a lot of you out there to possibly embark on a new career training. It's a school that can give you world-class student support so you never feel left out. They've got great opportunities and programs, job projection for growth, flexible term starts, 24/7 online accessibility. They also have a very extensive portfolio of degree programs with some of the lowest tuition rates across the country. And quite often you can transfer up to 90 credits toward any undergraduate degree that they offer. Different courses might include network security, application security, incident response, and investigation through their online BS in cybersecurity, one that I feel is quite compelling for a lot of you out there. So using our partner link down here in the description, as well as here on the screen, you guys can see it, snhu.edu/sneed. You can check out their programs, get more information, register for courses, and sign up for your future. Consider SNHU for your future coursework needs and getting a career in something very rewarding. Check them out. Link is in the description. SMT Nation, we back. Nation, we are testing the T-Mobile network here today. We're just going to do, I guess, a different version. Typically, what I do is I speed test capacity, but I want to do things a little differently today. I just want to do it on a kind of like an app-based kind of testing, and I want to download a very large file game, Call of Duty. We'll do this over the App Store. This is the iPhone 14 Pro Max, and this is a T-Mobile Magenta business line, and we're just going to download the game, and we're going to time it, and we're going to do it over three parts of the T-Mobile network, the LTE part, the 5G non-standalone network, which would be like the LTE 5G combo. And then since they do claim to have a nationwide standalone 5G network, we'll test that too. And we'll see how the downloading goes between the connections. So it's not really about speed per se, in the sense that let's, you know, check the throughput on the network. But it's more about time to content, you know, completing a task. So yes, it is kind of a speed test, but you want your downloads to be efficient. Maybe not necessarily an ookla speed test. So what I'll do is, I'll be testing it on the iPhone in terms of the download, and then we'll time it on the Pixel and see how this goes. And let's go ahead and get that started here first with LTE. All right, let's give this a go. Let's download it. All right, and once this clears, you can see it's 2.5 gigs on download. We'll start the clock, and it's on. Boom, we started. All right, I'll leave the camera on here running the test. We'll fast forward it just for the sake of time. And then we'll compare all three. Let's go. All right, there it is. Looks like about 2.5 minutes. Came in at maybe 2 minutes, 26, 27 seconds. All right, and that's LTE. Okay, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to delete the app because we got to do this again. And we're going to delete it for the sake of re-download. And let me go ahead and reset my stopwatch. That was over LTE. You guys will see there. Let's go ahead and turn 5G on. Oops. And it defaults to SA. I'm going to start with the NSA. And then we'll go to the SA. Difference there is the 5G standalone runs totally on 5G NR standard based connections, right? So no LTE support. No LTE network core. So we'll start first with the NSA because it does associate LTE channels with it. So let's go ahead and do that. And we agree to this, download, and we start. There you go. Clock is on. 5G NSA. Let's go. Just finished. There you guys have it. Just a shade over 7 minutes on the legendary 5G network for T-Mobile. Wow, that took forever. Okay, so I'm going to go ahead and delete this. We'll remove the app and delete it, and then we're going to re-download this. Jeez, that took forever. We're going to re-download this over the NSA network. Let's go ahead and run the last portion of the test. 5G on. We're going to turn standalone on, and it looks like the 5G UC finally kicked in. And maybe that helps us, because 7 minutes for a game download, pretty bad. The LTE was like one third of that. Crazy. All right, let's go ahead and download over the SA5G network. All right, boom. Clock started. And now we play the waiting game for the T-Mobile standalone 5G network. And 41 5GUC, top right-hand corner. All right, 45 seconds. Holy crap. All right, so that's the difference between the three. This video was annoying to make. what was the LTE? The LTE was a couple of minutes, maybe a few minutes. The 5G NSA was like 7 minutes plus. And then the SA5G was 47 seconds. So like if I'm living in and around this neighborhood, right off the I-480 State Road exit, I believe this is still considered Cleveland. I'm not sure if how close it is to either Parma or Brook Park. I think it's further west. Anyways, I don't know. Maybe the T-Mobile engineers in the area can figure out what's going on with the NSA network. That was painful. That was atrocious. Just the time it took to download the game on that segment of the network was pretty long. The LTE didn't perform that great. It's a big file, 2.5 gigs, so, you know, I don't know. But the NSA was atrocious. The SA was much better. Hope you guys enjoyed the video. Want to see more videos like this? Subscribe and turn on the bell notifications to never miss an upload. Ways to support the SMT. You like this type of content and you want to directly support your favorite creators. Links are in the description. And we shall see you all in the next video. Peace.